value relationships in your life? Or do you value materials in your life? Hello everyone. Welcome to Fitter Body Leads to Fitter Mind and Happy You. I am Dr. Rashmi. Before we get the answers for these two questions, here is a story that I want to share with you all. Once upon a time, there lived a king. He was very fond of his royal elephant. The king provided his elephant with the best food and a big tent to live in. The elephant was very happy and content with his life. A dog lived in the same kingdom. All day it would roam in every street possible. It was never able to eat enough food. It was weak and its bones were also showing under the skin. One day the dog was looking for food around the elephant's tent. When the dog peeped into the tent of an elephant, it was amazed to see all varieties of food which was arranged by the king to the elephant. It got tempted and got into the tent when mouth was not around. Dog started relishing all the food left over by the elephant. From that day onwards, the dog began to live in the tent with the elephant. And mouth was also ignorant about it. It seemed like the elephant didn't bother as well. In fact, the elephant formed a friend in dog. With time, their friendship also grew. Together, they began to live happily. The dog's health improved and it began looking cute as well. One day, a man came to visit Mao and he found this dog very attractive. So he requested Mao to give that dog to him. Since the dog was no use for Mao or for the king, he agreed to do it. And then man took the dog. The elephant became very sad because he was losing his only friend with whom he was sharing the tent. The elephant was very sad to have his friend taken away from him. He began to miss his dog so much, he stopped eating and fell sick. The best animal doctors were called to look at him. But no one could help the elephant. Then suddenly, Mahout remembered the dog which he had given away. He went ahead and shared the dog story with the king. And king understood the reason behind elephant sickness and he sent a messenger to announce in the city with a drum to bring back the dog which Mouth had given to a man. And he also announced for a huge gift from the king for returning the dog. The man who had taken the dog didn't do any delay in returning the dog. So once the dog was back in the tent with the elephant started eating its food and started regaining its health as well. This gave immense joy to the king and mouth. The elephant and dogs spent the rest of their life together in each other's company. So here is our learning from the story. We can all relate this story to our own relationships in our life. When we have such good bonding and relationships in our families, we end up running behind the money, which gives you more and more of materialistic things. Once you have all that, that is when you look back and realize that all your relationships have been left behind. Striking a right balance between materialistic things and relationship is equally important to be successful and stay there being successful as well. When you're all alone, when you reach or attain that success, life doesn't mean anything to you. So this story is not only applicable to your relationship, it is also applicable to your health. When we all are blessed with a good health, we hardly value it and take care of it well. The minute you are diagnosed with some diseases, That's when you start valuing your life and you work so hard towards achieving it. The more you focus on what you have and value it, there'll be less chances that you will lose it and feel bad for it later as well. I want to end this video with a quote. Value not the things that you have in your life, but rather who you have in your life. Thank you so much for spending your valuable time with me. I hope this video has helped you to make a wise decision between your relationships or your materialistic things. Do take care, keep smiling, and see you soon.